Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another vlog here in Skinny Atlas. This will probably be the last vlog for this time we're up here, and we got a few things planned. Since it's pretty much fall time here, leaves are falling, literally. You can take a look and see. There's leaves. It's fall. But not really. Anyway, we're doing some fall things today. Today we're going to an apple orchard, and we might pick some apples. We're more just going to take a walk and get some cool photos. And tomorrow we're going to Fillmore Glen Falls, and that'll be fun. So, you know how much I'm into waterfalls. You remember Canada vlog, we went to a few, and it was a good time. So hopefully this should be just as good, these falls. New York is known for them, with Watkins Glen, this, and a few other spots. So yeah, should be fun, and make sure to stay tuned. So the village is still pretty packed, not as packed as Memorial Day. Nowhere near as packed as that. But yeah, it's still pretty packed. It always is. So that is a Tisco Lake. This is the first time seeing this Finger Lake. So we've seen Skinny Atlas, Tisco. Alaska was the other one. Alaska. Those are the three that we've seen so far. Alright, here we are. There's a big barn, tent, some trees. It's in a nice area. I mean, look at that view behind us, all down a mountain. So yeah, pretty nice. Let's go see what kind of apples they have. Oh, by the way, this is called Beak and Skiff, if you haven't seen yet. So I first thought this name was Beacon Skiff, but now it's Beak and Skiff, which isn't as fun to say, but oh my god, look at that view. It's gorgeous. So it's looking as if we can only get into the fields if we pay for Pick Your Own, but still some cool stuff around here. It's gorgeous. Wonder if it runs or if it's just a shell. So we don't have to pay to get in here, but we have to pay for the apples, which I might get a few. They're $1.30 a piece. I mean, I'll get like one or two. There we go. So we are in a spot where we cannot pick the apples because they are not ready yet. Although they look kind of ready, I don't know. However, they are not ready, I know. I'm not picking, eh? So now we have to head over to the spot where they are ready and spend an exorbitant amount of money on apples. Alright, we're finally in the apple area where we can pick. So, got our nice little bag. Now we have to pick apples. I don't know if we're gonna do that or not. I don't know if they're ready or not. Pick sunglasses. As you can see here, we have some apples. They might be ripe, they might be not. I don't know. They'll come home with us. By the time we get them home, they'll be ripe. They're for my parents. So let's just do some more walking around and then go pay for these. And then they have apple donuts that look pretty good. So we might stop and get one of those before we leave back down at the barns and stuff. These rotten apples are really a strong scent. It's quite the vibe. Quite the vibe right there. I don't think we're too interested in the Paula Reds here. So we'll probably head on back now. We got the ones we're interested in. I'm just sitting here marveling at this view. I mean, that is pretty. That's really pretty. Can't really see that from the rest of the farm though, which kind of sucks. Okay, so apparently it was $1.30 a pound, not an apple, so price was pretty good actually. Now we're gonna go and check out their baked goods and stuff like that. Find a pretty little spot like that to eat. There's a few pretty little spots to eat. So that over there is their brewery, because they do vodka and hard cider, obviously.
I think there's also a sit-down restaurant.
They looked it. Well, you want to do that for lunch or what? We got an apple barn for people who don't want to pick their own apples. General store and the bakery. It smells just like any general store smells in the fall. There's already Christmas stuff out. That is absurd. Heck yes, Straw Mountain. We're gonna see if their restaurant's open in here. I'm hoping it is, because this looks like a neat little place to eat. And then we'll check out the bakery and call it a day. So yeah, 1911 is their brewing company, but we have to go around to get to the tavern. So apparently they close the tavern. Maybe we'll get something when we're back in town for food, but for now we're just gonna go to the bakery. So this is the bakery and cafe. We got some sandwiches from the cafe, our apple cider, and then I got an applewood smoked pork, so very apple themed, and then we're gonna get some apple cider donuts when we're done. So all apple themed. Solid 10 out of 10 on the presentation of the food. Let's see how it tastes. Alright, now we're trying some apple cider donuts with more apple cider. These look very good. Alright, so that's pretty much all for Beacon Skiff. Tomorrow we'll head to the falls and maybe stop at the village at some point too tomorrow, which would be fun. And then we head out Wednesday, so yeah, coming to a close pretty soon. So, we've tried to get out to Great Gully Falls. We aren't going to Fillmore Glen anymore. Apparently, it's a lot of parts are closed off because of COVID. But we're out here in the middle of nowhere. We found a gully. It is quite a gully. I'm not going to get out again because there's quite a lot of dead animals and it smells terrible. But it is a gully. And it's very deep. But it's not the one. So we're going to head to Aurora, New York. Which isn't far from here. I don't know why this is located as Great Gully Falls, because it's not. It is a state park. This is not. This is a spot someone could get killed. However, we're gonna go and find the right place now, and yeah, hopefully have a good day at the falls. So that out there is Cayuga Lake. This is probably this is the fourth lake we've seen so far. Cayuga, and there's also a lake called Cayuga. So this is the village of Aurora. We're heading towards Wells College. Wow, is it a church?
It's a library.
We're heading to Wells College because we've been told the falls are right after Wells. I think when we're done the falls, we'll come back here and maybe, I don't know, maybe we'll get a lunch, I don't know. So that's Wells College. We looked on a map, and we did find that in the little area that we were before, at that big drop-off, there was a spot to park. Meaning there's most likely a spot to go down and find the falls. But we're in Aurora now, so we might as well walk around Aurora first and enjoy Aurora. Beautiful lake next to us. So yeah, we'll probably do just that first and head on back. We gotta go back that way anyway. We'll head on back and stop at the falls. Hopefully we can actually find it. So we're headed to a little cafe called The Grind. It's supposedly a student-run cafe since this is a college town. There's not much else to do here. I don't know.
In 3/4 of a mile, take a slight left turn.
It's just all housing. The one antique store that's here is closed. And the library is open for appointment only. So, not really much to do. But we'll go to the cafe. Because Hannah needs a lot. And then we'll go to Mackenzie Childs. And then we'll go try to find the falls one last time, and if that doesn't work, we're headed home. Alright, well, we're on campus here. It's a nice little campus. I mean, it gets a good view of the lake, so that's pretty good in my opinion. But let's go try to find the grind. Okay, we're having no luck finding this place, and all these places here you have to have pre-approval to go in because it's a college. So I think we're going to head home, or not home, but just go straight to Mackenzie Childs now, because this is a mess, and we have bees chasing us now. So, Aurora College, definitely, or Wells College in Aurora. All right, here we are at the famed Mackenzie Childs place. I'm not sure what there is to do here, other than get some overpriced decor. But it looks pretty cool, very pretty place. So, good. give you guys a tour. Alright, so here is the famed Mackenzie Childs entrance. It's actually very pretty. More checkered stuff, because that's their thing. If you don't know what it is, it's basically a design brand here in upstate New York that does everything checkered like that. There's a ton of it back at the camp, and the house, and everywhere. Well, the refreshments are closed, but you can get a look at the inside there. Quite a place. Oh my lord. The shop. Is the shop open?
Yes.
Okay, cool. That's what we're really here for, right? This is very pretty. Nice little courtyard. Oh my. So they don't only do the checkered pattern.
I need it.
It's my cat. How much is it?
$88.
It's a little strange with all the checkered, but you know, it's nice. I feel bad walking on these rugs. Let's avoid the rugs. Pumpkins are cool. They have all their fall stuff out. So we're looking at prices here. For this, it's over $400 for that weird little tray.
The water thing.
Good God. Oh my.
Look at the tiny hand dish. That's so cute.
I mean, it looks cool and all, but why are you paying that much for that?
Well, it's all handmade and hand painted.
Oh,
so it's all one of a kind.
Oh man. So that's pretty cool. They paint things on site here and you can watch them. That's interesting. That's different. The bathtub's cool. It's really cool. That is way too much color. It's freaky. What's with the little flowers on it? It's just way too much. Yeah, the whisk is cool, but the clock's pretty cool too. It's different. $22.
$32.
Oh, good God. Okay, so that's all for Mackenzie's Childs. Now let's go and try to find the gully. We're gonna head back the way we were. It's a little inlet, basically, that's just a parking lot. And then you walk to the gully. And there should be a lot of stuff at the gully, but the real question is, can we get to the gully? That's what we're gonna try to see. And if we can't, you know, we'll just head back, maybe go to the village in town, Skinny Atlas, and because that's a village you can walk around and enjoy. Unlike Aurora, which is just a college town. But yeah, we'll see what happens. All right, I can successfully say that we have made it. This is just the parking lot, obviously, but you go back there, and there is a gully. A great one, hopefully. Ooh, I can hear the water already. This is indeed great gully. Wow, this is really pretty. And really chilly. Good, because I was burning up. I have a feeling that this is not the biggest of the falls, so let's take that little trail up there. This is a very steep hike, but it'll definitely be worth it when we get to look down at the waterfalls. So the path kind of just ends. Like, I don't know where it's supposed to go.
There's more path down there.
Down where? There?
Down in that back, but I don't know how to get there from here.
We have to go into the rocks way back there. Oh, alright, so we've realized we gotta take the rocks to get anywhere here because the little trails up there don't do anything. We are in a land of rocks right now. Look at this. I hear falls, but we can't find the falls. So. Yes, typically that's the way it works, but yeah, it's very rocky, but we're having a good time. I'm just happy we found the place. Here we go, more mini falls. These are cute.
Aren't they?
Yes. So, this is the falls. Makes a good photo, but yeah, New York's going through a bit of a drought. Sadly, as you can see by all this bare rock. So they aren't much right now, but somewhat worth the rock.
I have a rock in my backpack, that's why I just said that. Somewhat worth the walk. Still make some cool photos. But yeah, that's pretty much it. All the falls are pretty much either messed up because of COVID and not being able to travel on them, or dried up because drought. But yeah, it still looks pretty fun. Does look like a fun place to swim if there's more water. Alright, so we're here in the village. We're actually just finished up here in the village. About to head back to the house now. I don't know how much more content I've got. We're pretty much just going to be getting everything ready to leave tomorrow. I'm going to get up, help with a few more trees, cut down a few more trees at the camp, the house in the morning, and then we're hitting the road. So, yeah. Hope you guys have been enjoying it so far. Alright, this is our last boating excursion for the trip. It only goes in circles, though, and chases Hannah. Alright guys, so that's pretty much all for these Skinny Atlas vlogs. We're all packed up in here and pretty much ready to go. We're just going to say our goodbyes and head on out. But we had a good time. We've done a few good fun things. We didn't record as much this time. There was still a lot from last time. I still haven't even uploaded the ones from last time. I'm backed up. I know. But I'm working on it. They should be coming up soon, and as well as these. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to leave a thumbs up. Subscribe for more content. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.